Welcome everybody to the first Latitude 37 in our 2018 Local Heroes series. I wanted to say again, big thank you to the Melbourne Recycle Centre for having us back again. We just love to be here. So we're dedicating this entire concert to the Folias progression and melody, which will be familiar to many of you. And when we had a look at putting this program together, we thought, oh, might it be boring to just do a whole concert on the same theme? We realised, actually, no, we don't think it is. It's really cool. And we were struggling to decide what not to put in the program. So the Folias is a, for those who don't know, it's a particular harmonic progression that has a typical melody that's usually used, and well, according to Wikipedia, over 150 composers over the last 330 years have composed sets of variations on this progression, which thought to have appeared somewhere maybe even as far back as the 15th century, certainly the 16th century, as a fertility dance in triple time, somewhere on the Iberian Peninsula, maybe Italy, then not sure. But yeah, so composers even as far forward as Liszt and Rachmaninoff, even Vangelis used the progression in a charting number. So it's inspired so many composers, and we're going to move to France, the lushness of the court of Louis XIV, and so this is a set of variations by the gamba virtuoso composer Marin Marais. So he wrote this big long set of couplets de folies, and I remember one of my first gamba teachers, Miriam Morris, saying to me when I was a student, "Laura, if you can play all of these variations, you will have mastered all the technical skills you need to play anything ever written on the viola da gamba." So you can tell me later how.
Thank you. becomes my page turner. So when Laura mentioned this concept of the Folias being a fertility dance, I think it's impossible not to immediately think of, think of the Rite of Spring. And I think this idea of, you know, the performer slash the dancer working themselves up into the frenzy, and then finally, you know, collapsing, usually dead. That was, of course, I think what appealed as much to Stravinsky as I think the Folies bass line appealed to the musicians of the 17th century. Certainly, I think it was in this period, the 17th century, that this idea of extreme emotional changes and certainly working oneself to the point of collapse and worse really seemed to have taken form, I think, during this period in the 17th century. I'm going to do the Folias, obviously, by Alessandro Scarlatti. Now, when we think of Alessandro Scarlatti, we tend to think of, you know, the beautiful cantatas and some of the first works that were being written for the cello. And we think more about the harpsichord Scarlatti being Domenico, who was Alessandro's son. We think, you know, it was Domenico who had all the fireworks. But there's a wonderful collection of toccatas by Alessandro Scarlatti, of which this is drawn from one. But what makes these pieces so remarkable, and I think also this is why they tend not to appear in the repertoire all that often, is they're all about 25 minutes. So this is just a solo harpsichord piece, just by itself, no one else around, just you. And this folia appears at the end of the toccata in D minor. And I think it begins with this cascade of arpeggios, and it just doesn't stop for the next 25 minutes. It just keeps going. You have a few moments of recitative style, but it refuses to give up. And I think the idea of using the folia at the very end is a very strong statement, I think, of Alessandro Scarlatti, because... I think from a listening point of view, it's exhausting to hear so much harpsichord. And certainly I know that 25 minutes of non-stop harpsichord playing, even as a performer, is extremely, taxing. But I think that's certainly... I won't be giving you the full version, obviously, because we haven't got 25 minutes of... And I simply just haven't got the time to learn a 25-minute toccata piece. I'm sorry. So you're just going to get the best part of it, which is the folios. Very nice.
Thank you. We're going to play a piece by Jean-Pierre Guignon. His real name was actually Giovanni Pietro Guignone. He was born in Turin, and he worked at his final post was in Versailles as part of the Concert Spirituel there. He was well known for his performances of Vivaldi, as well as French music. And the interesting thing is, and there's a lot of cross-pollination in this program, because he studied with a violinist called Somis. And Somis was actually a student of Corelli's. And also Somis taught composers like Leclerc. So you've got Italian influencing Italian, then taking it to France, and then doing a French Folies from Spain.
Thank you.
we are really excited to be premiering a brand new work. Nobody, apart from Rose and the composer, had ever heard it before. And we're so happy with how it came about. We did a played in the Metropolis New Music Festival here last year, and the composer of the next piece, Jordan Hayes, was at that concert. And as a winner of, I believe it's called the Composers Initiative that the Melbourne Recital has run, which was a composition commissioning program, great idea, in collaboration with Melbourne University. So Jordan Hayes was at the concert that we played at Metropolis and thought, hey, I'd actually like to write a piece for these guys. So we had a talk about what he might do, and we thought Folias might be something that might tie everything together. So Jordan wrote in his notes at the start of the piece that while writing for period instruments and is still exhibiting the hallmarks of La Folia, the crux of this piece, Ego Folium, exists in the development of multiple different motives rather than variations, without altering the key, harmonic structure, or instrumental context, and aims to retain the integrity established in the opening bars. We like that bit. And he says, playing on the notion that the historical folia, or folly, sometimes represented a feeling of descending into madness, here you go, Donald. Ego folium, from the Latin I am belief, delves into and examines the frailty of all human minds, and the journey that thoughts, feeling, and emotions can take in this state.
Thank you.
We've got another one here. So this is an English publication from 1684. And the composer is, he's called Farinelle. He's actually Michel Farinelle. And he was born in Grenoble and studied with Carissimi in Rome. And this is, as I said, an English publication. This is probably one of the only pieces that we really know of Farinelle. But it's the Folias bass line in D minor, the Spanish Folias that we've heard a few times tonight. But the interesting thing is, it was actually written before Corelli's famous one. So it's a violin piece. It sounds very similar, but it's not that one.